Yo, what's up guys, Zio here, and today I'm bringing you kind of a different video. I've never done a video like this before, ever, but yeah, for those of you new people, this is pretty much going to be telling you about my channel and what I do and how long I've been around and where I came from. So if you haven't known me that long, or if you don't know much about me, or if you know me and you don't like know like what I do, I'm just going to explain it in the video. So what's up guys, I'm Zio. I'm 19, I'm from New York, and I play a fuck ton of different games and I've been a bunch of places. So let's start off by showing you my channel was created October 6, 2012. So that was obviously like 5 years ago, and it's been a long crazy ride, and I've been through a lot, and I'm here to tell you guys the story. So, yeah, if you're wondering how I got 1.3k, I obviously should have it over a span of this much time. But, yeah, so this is my YouTube, go sub. This is my Twitter right here, at oldgengod. So, this is my Twitter, follow me. And, this is actually a montage I'm doing called Expansion. I'm going to show you guys the trailer in a minute. But basically, it's every Call of Duty ever into one montage, and it's actually going to be a total of 160 clips, because I'm adding Call of Duty 1 clips to it, 10 of them. The reason I'm adding 10 more is because COD Classic and COD 1 are two different games. COD 1 is PC, COD Classic is Xbox. They're both very, very, very extremely similar, but Xbox has a lot of patches for the glitches and stuff. And it's just a lot more fun on PC, in my opinion, to be honest, but I'll always choose COD Classic. But yeah, so here's my Twitter, go follow me, I'm pretty lit. This is my Twitch, I haven't used it since 2015. I might start using it again, depending on what you guys, like, you know, want to see and stuff. But basically, this is my stream, go follow me. I'll link everything right here down in the description below. But I like to stream like campaign trickshotting stuff, so just, you know, just a little on the side thing. So I don't know, just do whatever, follow, sub, whatever. But where did I come from? You know, where did this trickshotter come from? From 2012, did he like teleport in time or what? No, I actually started off small. In 2012, I started in a team scale. I didn't start the team, but I actually like joined off an RC, private RC. So the team's long gone now, but on an old editor's channel, he has one of the episodes where I'm actually in it. So, yeah. I'm breaking in, shaping out, then checking out on the prison. There I am, Logic Zio. That was my gamer tag, but yeah, I was in this team called Scale. And as you can see, there's a thing on the intro called Top 30 Trickshot Clans, okay? And this used to be the most popular channel on YouTube. All the underrated teams would just submit their cams, and there used to be rankings for what trickshot teams were the best, which brings me to this channel. This channel is, it's similar to that one. It took the same rebrand and stuff, but as it says right here, it is that channel, but it's on this one because the old one got hacked. And this was on November 18th, 2012. So, this is actually how trickshot teams were ranked. They were ranked on, this originally, but before the channel, like after the channel got hacked, it moved to a different channel. But it was the same concept. It was just one of these channels. You know, it doesn't have many subs, 30k. And then they have a document that has rankings on it for all three consoles. And the cool part about it is this channel used to upload a whole bunch of teams' cams. Just have these teams you probably haven't even heard of. Because literally, oh, I didn't even mean to click on that. But like, Anxiety, who's that? Like, have these teams you probably haven't heard of. Literally, like, it's just the community used to be so much different. The community used to be just a bunch of people hitting trick shots and putting them together in cams, and then, you know, it was all about fun. It was never about uploading or anything. I know a lot of people upload cut cons and stuff now. But, like, it all used to be just one tight-knit community with a whole bunch of people that were just having fun. And that's what it was all about. That's literally, that was the greatness in the community, pretty much. But now everybody makes cut comms and makes fun of each other. And now I feel like there's only a couple clans that compete with each other. When in, you know, back then, it was literally a whole bunch of teams. There weren't, like, one, two, three good teams. There were a bunch of good teams. Like, all these teams are good. It was just, like, the community's changed so much. Now, we're going to go right ahead to the actual rankings. So, yeah, this is very nostalgic for some people. Top 30 Trick Clans right here. Xbox 360 Sora actually was above FaZe for the rankings because, like I said, it was about the, you know, the trick shot content back then. It didn't really matter like how many cut comms or whatever if you were a YouTuber. So Sora actually got above FaZe on that list. And, you know, we're going to go down the list here on all three of these, and we're just going to, like, talk about them. So obviously, Obey, Synergy, Saw, Dare, like, you'll recognize a lot of these names. Rush, I don't know if anybody remembers them. They were a team that started like after Arrow. Sparks was the original owner and leader. Cool dude. Despise, obviously, a complex trickshot team. Not really known by like a lot of people who create content because they mainly focus on the trick shots. Psycho, you see in there. Astral was an old team. Super's on there twice. The gods are on there, of course. Vatican. Vatican was a team. Now, if you guys remember from way back when, if anybody's a 2012 watcher, Vatican was a team that started after this team called SS, Style and Simplicity. And Style and Simplicity ended in the day after that Vatican started by the same leaders. So they were pretty good. Macis was a good team I was in. Respire, I still see that name getting thrown around a little bit. Ruin, I can honestly say I don't remember. Arise, I remember just because my friend was the leader. IR, I'm clueless. Aquila, I've heard of them. Rome, obviously a good team. And then, obviously, there's not four spots. Phillips, for some reason. But for PS3, Dare actually came up top. And that surprised me. Dare actually used to be a really, really insane trick shot team on PS3. One of the best, and Synergy was second, actually. I would put Synergy at first right now, actually, to be honest. Saw, Astral again, Psycho. A lot of these are repeats, except for Direct was on there, and they were pretty good. Vatican's on there again, Despise, Aspire, Maces. Urban, a little like B team of SB right there, hitting it up on PS3 rank. Super on the PS3 rank, ranked higher on PS3 than they are on Xbox. Aquila again, higher on PS3. Fast, I'm clueless. Avail, I don't remember. FJ, what the fuck is that? Diverse, I remember because Fleist, the homie. Arise on there again. Trilogy, I remember them. They were a very, very pretty OG team. Variate, I'm clueless. Ruin was also on Xbox, so they must have had a name for themselves. Zodic, I don't remember. Dystopia, I don't remember. Olympus, I don't remember. Fortune, I don't remember. Azora, I don't remember. Rome is on there again. XE, I don't remember. And then Rule, I don't remember. So, Jesus Christ, this is so nostalgic. There's just a lot. This is how the community was based. This is how you got your name out there, was by getting on this channel and clicking links and going and trying for those teams, because those teams are the teams that everybody would watch and that this channel would upload the cams for. So on PC we have a Dive. If you don't know what a Dive is, they're the best PC trick shot team ever. They were the most OG. When I first watched them, I couldn't even tell they were PC. Great MW2 team. A4, I don't remember. I don't remember a lot of these PC teams. I recognize Virtue. Obviously, Virtue and Dive, two of the biggest PC trick shot teams ever. So what does this have to do with me? So obviously, I'm not a content creator. I'm a trick shotter. Like, this is what I started out with. This is what I started doing, is looking and trying to make my way up the ranks and, like, make it to a higher team each time. That's how it would work. Now it's just, like, it depends on the connections you have and people you know and everything. Back then, you could message any one of these leaders on Skype and get a reply. I messaged so many FaZe members. I messaged, Saul was number 5 and number 3 in the world at the time. I messaged Vigos when he was around, and he instantly replied to me, and I linked him a shot, and he said it was great, and that, you know, at the time, I only had, like, one shot, so he told me to keep working, and I'd get in Saul one day.
You know, Bigos was a really cool guy. People, it's not even the team that he was in. It's just the fact that you could reach out to a big team leader and you can get a reply. You can get that feedback. You can work with them. They would openly discuss things with you because they care. Like, now people don't really care. Leaders are off doing their own thing. They don't really reply to people, and it's just annoying. But, you know, back then it was a lot more close-knit, you know, a lot more, like, you know, it wasn't as many people, and there were just a lot of teams popping up, you know, out of nowhere. And, you know, they all seemed to be good. So where did I start? This is my first episode I wanted to share with you guys. ZeoZone 1, it dropped in June 5th of 2013. So this was one of my favorite episodes. It's been a lot. It's light work, baby. And I know what you said. I can't get it out my head. I just don't know what you expect me. Oh my God, no. You want me to come and find you. It's light work, baby. And I know what you said. I can't get it out my head. I just don't know what you expect me to do. I'm looking for you. Good time in the end, can you feel that? Got a drink, no ice, can you chill that? I play by me with a feel that. Got no time for the noise, can you kill that? New school style, old school slow. All night lifestyle, yes I know. I came a long way from the clumped up bricks. Now everywhere I go, rock clumped up kicks, huh? See me poolside with the red cup. Lay back on the beach chair.
Nostalgic. So that was my first episode, and I only ended it because of time purposes. I actually recorded this video already. It was an hour long, and it was great, but my computer crashed, and I'm so mad. This is my second episode. I do a lot of series, like this is Kill Cam not included. Was a series I did in Team Deathmatch with a couple friends. We would go for shots, mid-games, and every game, like every time we recorded it, we were trying to hit more. So, I actually hit a shot this episode. This was a while ago. This is just I just thought of it because, like, people, I don't really know. I just wanted to go for mid-games. Because I guess I couldn't party up and I made a video out of it. So...
But everybody is just like...
I went for that OG 720
wall bang! What?
So I actually went for this wall bang. The funny part of
it. Oh, I hit!
No!
Oh my God, I hit. Yes, I hit the wall bang.
Wall bang?
Yeah.
So obviously, these are old uploads, and these are obviously, these are really cool. And, okay, you see I have an RC response right here? I've won every RC response I've gone for ever. So obviously,
if I've gone for Phase 5 or something, I never fucking submitted a response for that. Jesus Christ, I'd have used out the ass.
So any RC I dropped a video for, I won. So I actually went for this team drop off the Top 30 Church Shot Clan channel, and... this was a team that really helped me get started because I was just playing like crazy. This was a really cool VO2 shot I hit. It wasn't the best, but it was like really the boss and I over spot. Grunts, get ready for the next round. You know, it was just cool. It was just cool. And this was also another cool shot right here. On the ground with a wall bang. Bang. And the funniest part of this is the reaction. The funniest part is the reaction. Oh, I love that. So yeah, I won that RC, and then I just went on to do a little bit more of my own thing. Let me know if you guys want to see a video like this again. I'm going to play it for you. It's called Get in the Zone. I was thinking of doing it again. It's like a challenge shot series, see? And I was giving away Microsoft points and PSN cards, and it was just lit. So I showed where the spots actually were and where the dummy is supposed to stand, just so everybody knows. And then I showed people how to get up.
Yo, what is up, guys?
Showed an example shot.
Going for it before you got off, like when you died. And then did you see the kill cam when it like almost filled in that rave? Oh my
Nothing
god, no.
fancy, obviously. Oh my just god. A little, like, you know, just to get people to, like, know what to go for. And then I went for this little thing. He was in the elevator. And, you know, just some cool little spots that I'd like to see people, other people hit in private matches.
You win.
Now, this is obviously just a private match. I did it on five games. Even back then, I like to play all the games. But, yeah, as you can see right here, I actually did prizes for it. You know, the prizes were pretty generous, to be honest. I might do it again, so let me know if you guys want to see something like that, because it did pretty well the first time. And something I used to edit, I used to try and edit back in 2013. This was my edit, me trying to edit my own episode. This is my episode 5 with my friend. I was doing a duel.
Hey, man. You remember Stephanie's little cousin?
Yeah. Yeah,
a little feminine motherfucker. Used to be scared of the football.
This beat is great, man.
Yeah, man.
I love fucking.
Nah, I saw you the night downtown. Wildin' out, man. It's crazy. Running around, hitting waving a gun at rap boys.
I get all cinematic myself, to be honest.
Hey, Lord, I heard you got those trees.
Obviously,
wait, though, you can't possibly be even 13. What you doing open this late? Ain't got no older brothers
to
put you in place. Yeah, I know, you gotta get your hustle on and life does go on. It runs like nothing's wrong. State law says you're too young to work, but a couple of bucks to put a gun up under your shirt. Coke, weed, junk, and speed. Teach me another type of hide and seek. Chemistry, economics, math, and business. Already a pimp before high school's finished. Even the rich kids get in the mix.
Same differences
them bitches did as kids. And we quick to say it's just a game of stealth. They gave you that rope so you could hang yourself. Because
hey kid, where did you go? We made you grow up.
It wasn't that bad. Okay. Let's see. So we got a couple more episodes after that. Another response that I had. But first, I'm gonna show you guys this live commentary in SND, because this is what got me started into like actually making like live comms and stuff. Because you guys know, like, I like to make live Twitch channel videos. Obviously, this is the first one of my many uploads. It's a little different because you guys know I don't really like to make like videos besides live Twitch shouting. But this is just going to start it off. This is just a little background information for you guys. So this is what got me started into doing live commentaries and stuff.
Defuse, go get ready to defuse, go
actually,
get ready to defuse.
I actually hit Marker to shot and I freaked out.
Oh my god, he's going to kill me! No. Yes! Oh my god! No!
So I hit Marker to shot in the live comm, and then I went for this clan called Visify, and I actually won the response. I'm going to look for a pretty cool clip here. I'm trying to, I think, I want to show you guys, like, the best, like, only the best shots. Okay, hold on, I'm going to show you guys this. So I got up in this glitch spot, right, and I hit Marker it 3 times, so it's hard to see, but there, you can kind of see it, like, right there. The video quality shit. But I hit Margaret the first time, and I looked up, and I was like, what the fuck? Because I didn't think I hit Margaret. Like, the person, like, back then, people used to set up, so the setup was like, oh, somebody hit Margaret me, and then I was like, oh, damn. And then I hit Margaret him again, but I didn't know right there. He told me somebody hit Margaret again. And I was thinking, like, maybe that kid hit Marker or something, you know. And then I think this time is the one where I noticed I got the hit Marker. It is, because he actually told me that I hit Marker him 3 times. And I was just like, what the fuck? Like, that's fucking Jewish. But I actually ended up winning this RC response and joining Bizify. And I went 2 for 2 with RC responses, so I was pretty hyped. I got a couple more episodes edited. I edited my own. Let's see. I did another episode. It actually got edited by a guy named Nifs, and he's a really cool dude. He's a really sick editor. I'm going to show you guys that episode after I show you guys. This was another variation of my Road to Kill Cam videos, and I actually hit first round in this video. So we're gonna show you. I hit the freight wall bang with my friend Travel. Keep him in mind.
Oh my! He just hit the wall bang. I knew you were gonna. You fucking.
Oh my god!
That's the second shot you hit with me.
So obviously it was pretty crazy. None of us were expecting it. and Travel is in the game. Keep his name in mind, because the second episode of this was the most nuts episode ever. So we're playing, kid, and he brought me through the ladder.
Oh my god, Travel is a fucking dickhead.
But this happened.
Oh! Oh my god! 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 Did you just do that? Are you for real?
I asked him if he was for real about a shot that happened in front of my eyes. What the fuck, Theo? Such a retard. But yeah, let me know if you guys want to see more Road to Cocaine videos like these, because crazy shit does happen. I made some shits and gigs before. Hopefully this is the one I was thinking about. Play a funny clip real quick. This might be it. Oh, this is a cool clip. Peep that nigga, dude, look it.
No way.
Oh, what the?
Jesus Christ.
Dude.
Got him.
That was funny. That was funny. So wait. I actually did zoning out again with my boy Travel, and he hit first round. Like, he wasn't playing for a while, and then he just randomly gets back on for one game, decides he wants to do Road to Kill Game again.
Like, you hit it! First round!
We did.
Oh my god, no way!
No, you didn't.
No.
Travel.
Oh,
yes,
oh
Travel.
Oh my god.
Yes. Go on.
So my mic was crazy back then, but we were all having a crazy good time. And, you know, like I said, if you guys want to see more Road to Kill Cams, let me know. But, alright, what are we on to next? Okay, this is the best episode ever that got edited by for me, ever. So I used to be in a team called Tapic, they were pretty cool. Most of the Arcane dudes were in it. Arcane was a pretty good team, I'll explain those later. But for right now, let's just watch the edit. I swear to God, Nips doesn't play Xbox. He didn't send me a message. He edited that in. This is a pretty cool shot. I love playing the alone. Here's the wall bang. Okay, tell me Nips is not the best editor on Earth right here. Hold on. You notice how there's smoke leaks on this map? Like, watch. That's not a snowflake. That's not a snowflake. That's not a snowflake. But, like, it wasn't meant for you to, like, see it. Like, look it. Look quickly. So you can see it because I showed you, but, like, in, like, first glance, it looked like a snowflake. This is my 10th episode. Easily one of my best. I love all of you. This was the most random shot ever. I randomly went for it. I didn't even know where he was, to be honest. Not this shot, but the end of the shot. This is the perfect clip to end on, too. So pretty. I love Nips. Nips is a great editor. Alright, let's see. On to the next page. So, obviously, I have a lot of videos, and I have a large history, but we're gonna get through it, guys. Don't worry, just sit tight. So, I actually used to be a content creator back then. I used to start content creating, but then I realized that, like, you know, I'd love to just, like, hit shots and, like, not do anything else, because, like, I don't know. I feel like having fun is better, but bringing back to the RC thing, Sore put out an AWRC and never announced
Yo,
the winners.
Yo, what's going on, guys? It's
I submitted a 9-minute response, and I, you know, they didn't announce the winners. But Bez commented on this. I think Bez is on this somewhere. Yeah, he's right there.
Don't rage,
you know,
too late.
A lot of people told me I should have gotten in. It starts off with a hit marker that I got, and then... Bang. So, like, obviously not the best AW clips now, but, like, who hits AW ladder solos? And, you know, I was just killing it back then. People wouldn't like AW at first when it came out.
I'm literally about to kill you, dude.
Oh my gosh. Okay, I'm calling.
So, yeah, I submitted this, and they never announced the winner, so fuck. I honestly think I should have won, though. But, anyways, a couple days after I submitted my RC, I submitted it early, I actually hit this. So, this was... If anybody can tell me where he was, I'll give you $50.
Nice work, Sentinel.
I really wish I got reaction for this shot. But, to debunk any of you who say, oh, he was jumping off blue building, I will pause it while he's jumping. He does not die. Like, he's still flying. Like, look it. Like, that nigga is still flying. He's not... No. So then, what else do we got? We got quite a bit. You guys are... I hope you guys are enjoying, because I just did this perfectly for an hour and just got fucked. Oh, this is one of my crazier shots. I hit it for Clash of the Clans. When SB Sway put out Clash of the Clans, it was a 75-60. And my friend Evan, who's an editor now, was helping me out, and he freaked out.
No!
This was actually opener to the Clash of the Clans.
Oh my god, no! No! Holy fuck! Holy shit! Oh my fuck! No!
So obviously that was a crazy shot. Let's see. So basically, yeah, just a whole bunch of content creating shit. Let's see. Yep, more content creating shit. Jesus Christ. I upload daily for the longest time. Okay. This brings us back to... I joined Hype, and I was tricked out after when I first started this mind using. Pretty cool shots in there. If you guys haven't noticed, I love going to different spots and different, like, you know, just keep the variety up and stuff. I also watch NJD a lot for Black Ops 2, it's patient. I love doing NJD for the other map. This is a 2880 throwing map, I'm pretty good. This is a little filler, I don't know what I put it in. This is a dope shot. The next shot, though, look at this. Oh my goodness. I don't care, like, how unusable BO2 is, I love that shot. This shot was also dope. This was after they passed quarters. I hit while I landed on somebody's head. And wait. One guy, two guy. There's a guy right there, and he died. Watch. Watch closely. He definitely died, because I look back in the mirror and that was the dude from the balcony I hit. So yeah, the introducing is still up on Hype if you want to watch. It's pretty cool. So then I got back into content creating a little bit, and I love doing top fly
I don't know what I just said. I love doing top fives and underrated YouTubers because it's just, it's so cool to help other people out, and, you know, especially, you know, other underrated people, other people that deserve recognition, you know, help anybody out any way you can. Like I said, you know, the trick shot community used to be close-knit, everybody used to help each other. Now it's just, like, kill yourself, faggot, pussy, retard, you know, like, nobody won't, like, come on, help each other out. So I love doing top fives. Always submit your clips by tweeting them at me. I love doing underrated YouTubers. And I actually did Spec Ops trick shotting while I was in Hype, and this is the best, one of my most successful videos, to be honest. So I'm just gonna I actually called it out, and I had to save Vayne's from dying, too.
I blew up my Claymore, but I didn't think I was gonna go.
I'm gonna build him real
so quick. I called it. I said I'm gonna build him real quick. And I freaked out just because.
I just called it. Dude, what the hell?
Yo, I'm dead. Oh no, you're dead.
And
oh
my god, we played Homeland Security a bit, and we got out of the map and whatnot. And I sped it up. But we, you know, this is what I like doing. I like doing glitches and shit, getting out of the map. And, so I retardedly jumped out and fell to my death right here. Went for a nice suey, I don't really know. But the last portion of the video was me and Vayne's on a race. We went to Modern Warfare 2 and we raced it on the snowmobiles. Dude, this is so fun. I remember making this video. But yeah, definitely let me know if you guys want to see some more videos like that. You know, I definitely have fun making them, and it's just great. So this was a leftover I had. I left over it because it was set up, but I mean, like, you kind of have to set up to get there, because it's a knife one spot, but I thought this was pretty cool. It was an MK14 final stand stall after I ballistic vest stall. I don't know, something about me just loves that shot, dude. It was so nice. I don't know, like, bang! Boom. And I like the way that I hit the ground as I shot, so the gun went away. Now, I also like to do, like, I don't know, spec ops. I did this spec ops spot, and they're all the way down there. And I messed up jumping off the first time, but then, you know, they're all the way down there. And I'm just like, okay, Bill Cam City. Bang. I fucked them up. Let's see. I also like doing, like, cool different stuff. I'll sometimes use mod menus, but not, like, it's not like I mod. Like, I don't mod, I don't have mod menus, I don't have modding friends. But on COD 4, you can get infectable menus.
Oh, shit!
And, I got a menu just for the purpose of making this video, because I want to do third-person trick-shotting. Now, obviously, you can't just do third-person trick-shotting on COD 4, so, if I'm ever going to use any kind of mod or anything to assist me to get out of the map, I'm going to tell you guys, first of all, and second of all, I'm going to record every second so that you guys know I'm not just turning on aimbot and then turning on record after. So, this was a pretty cool video. I really enjoyed making it, and, I actually hit right there.
Oh, shit! Oh, I just hit!
So, like, yeah, I really enjoy making videos like that, and, I have a bunch of stories, guys. You see these videos, I have a bunch of stories, with IRL friends and whatnot. We do so much shit, and we're, you know, I have a bunch of stories I can tell, so if you guys want to see story videos, you know, you definitely, you know, ask me, and I will. So I was in North, and, I actually started campaign trick shotting a little bit, so, dude. And then here it is, right here. I love campaign trick shotting level, doing all that weird stuff. That was pretty nice. So then after the campaign shots, I was hitting a bunch of out of maps on MW2. I hit this one. I thought it was pretty cool because. So I just show, in every clip I get out of the map, I show how I get out of the map so people don't question me. But I hit this.
Shut the fuck up. Oh. Hit? You hit? No, you didn't. No, you
I thought
didn't.
I hit, and I was like, what?
No,
idiot,
what?
So yeah, obviously pretty cool shot.
You know, I love doing Atom Apps so much. Let's see what else we got here. So this was a what if that I did. I thought it was the craziest what if ever. So this is a spot that I actually hit markered. I'm gonna show you the hit marker. I actually hit markered this shot. It's a painkiller glitch out of map on Wasteland, and then there's a tree outside of the map that you can actually knife lunge into.
Come here, come here.
And
no,
you can
don't
see across the entire map. So as you can see, I have painkiller on and getting like hit by the radiation, but then like staying alive after. So, you know, obviously that's fucking cool. And let me change the quality real quick because it's on like 188p for some reason.
Alright.
And see, like, I would never hit this. Like, this would never hit. Like, look where he is. Right there. Now watch.
Yeah.
Watch this. This is what I went for. Dude, imagine. Look it. Like, what?
If you fucking, if you, no. I'm not even gonna, I'm gonna look in the screen.
Like, dude, that would be the craziest shot in the world. So yeah, obviously I like going for some just cool shit. Let's see. I play other first person shooters besides Call of Duty. I play Gotham City Posse. Here's a little cool shot that I hit marker that I was so mad about. Aw, dude. I really wish I hit that. There's a lot of midair pauses and midair scoreboard pulls up. But yeah, after that, I joined a team called Old, and they're like an indie team, and they were really good. Xanta and all them edited their cams, and I actually hit this spot again for my first in the team, but it wasn't the same shot.
Oh, you fucking hit that, I saw that. That was fucking dope. There you fucking go, Zio.
Dang, nice little bill cam. Let's see what else we got. We got a couple more things. Let's see. Okay, so I like doing cool stuff. So I tried doing Rust parkour once, and I'm not sure how you guys would think, like what you guys would think in this video, like how it would come out or something. I just thought it was cool concept. I don't really see anybody do any parkour in a trick shot, but I thought that this incorporated it well. I was gonna, like, the reason it's on this is because I was gonna do a video, like, the cool little edit, like, three type clip video, but, you know, I wasn't sure if I should continue it or not, so I only like a couple people, but, you know, this was a pretty cool idea. I always like doing something different, like that. Let's see, where did we go from there? So, then, another MW2, this was one of the best shots I've ever hit, because it's, like, seeing an MW2 shot from a cool spot is cool, but, like, you know, if people use Super Jump or, like, UFO or something, it's just not the same, or if they use NoClip or something. But, you know, hitting it with a knife lunge is such a big accomplishment. Like I don't know, it just feels better. But I ended up hitting this beastly cam 1080 glide. My friend was
oh my god,
dude.
Oh my god, I was right there.
So pretty much, me and just all my friends would just chill and free for all, just literally hit all day. What else? So then brings me on to the one time I actually fucking hit markered the Atom map on Wasteland. So I got out, showed you guys how I got out before, and then
I use it and then change weapons. I do the normal thing and then change weapons.
Oh my goodness, I hit markered and I was so upset. That would have been the best shot in the world. I actually have, the hit marker is actually in an arcane video that I'm going to show you guys in a second. So yeah, and I like doing one of the chamber trick shotting, so expect to see some of those videos from me. You know, I love like different game modes and shit. And just bang, you know. I know that shot was a little choppy, but you're gonna see in the kill cam it looked pretty dope. Mm-hmm. Nice little 1080. Bang. That's pretty dope. I fucked with it. Let's see. So then after that, I did a Road to Kill Camp with my boy Jibble and Wolfed and all them. And I actually hit a shot while we were doing it.
Yo, what's going on, guys? Zio here, bringing you live S&D Trick Shot on COD 2, and I'm here with Wooked, Jibwa, and Bud.
Say what's up. Trying to find the shot right now.
So we're on Tujane. I always enjoyed like content creation.
Are you gonna just like have it like just eliminated?
No! Oh my God! What the fuck? No, I'm doing uncut, like, cause I'm tired of like watching cut comms, and I'd rather like
whenever I always enjoy like content creating,
but like when it's,
I don't like
cut
comms.
I enjoy
that's the real shit.
You know what I'm saying?
Like
more than I did with a cut comm talking about somebody's 3-year-old sister losing their virginity. Like,
preach, Zio.
I don't want to know about that. Yeah. I just want to. He rushed mid. What a surprise.
Where is the shot that I hit, dude? I don't think
anyone's hit off. I do not see. Oh, yo, he's camping in that one square building. He's coming after me.
Okay, what the fuck? You know what? We're just gonna play the clip because I'm not looking through all that.
Ladder side, I think.
Go for that 360 left over.
Just
eliminate.
Oh, so obviously I hit more than the 360 and Jibble was just playing around, but you know, we were all freaking out. That was a pretty good shot. Once again, I might do more Road to Kill Cams. This is the best MW2 shot I ever hit.
Come and get a bomb.
I have full round for this shot on my computer. Let me know if you want it uploaded.
Yeah, I'm in the air, dude, on Sui. I'm on. Oh my God, dude! Oh, dude, I thought.
So obviously, Jesus, what the fuck just happened? So basically, what happened was I went for a 720 stop and stare over the shoulder with the sniper before the host migration happened. I didn't know the kid was gonna leave, like, he wasn't in the party. So I was just gonna switch weapons after I shot because I think that was really clean. And I ended up doing that right before the host migration, and when it came back up, I knew I had to move a little bit right to hit the shot, and I was going to pop shot with my sniper, but my deagles were already set to come out, and I forgot about that, and both my deagles shot, and both of the bullets hit him across the map, and I was just freaking out. So once again, bringing it back to the challenge. You didn't know his new and you shit, you ain't no savage. Let me know if I should do another one. You didn't know his new and you shit, you ain't no savage. You ain't no savage. You didn't know his new and you shit, you ain't no savage. You ain't no savage. You niggas so average. God damn, you niggas so average. Damn. You didn't know his new and you shit, you ain't no savage. So I actually did this for money prizes. I actually gave you guys that idea. You don't trust myself, can't trust no bitch, no, I can't have it. So, bang, there we are. And, you know, I might do a couple more of those, but, let's see. I actually found a new knife lunch spot on Derail. It's so complicated. We just had to use care packages and shit. Basically, care package and stack and strafe jump until I got on top of that fence. And then I had a reflexive fire shotgun knife lunge onto this dude to get into the barrier for the corner of the pole. So this was in private match, obviously, but it has to be in reflective, friendly fire for you to be able to achieve it at all. So, you know, it kind of sucks, but I'd love to hit it online one day if anybody wants to party up on it. So obviously, cool shot. You don't really see anything like that. Let's see. What else? I started trick shot on COD Classic and COD 2 and all that. You know, started getting into what I trick shot on now for a lot. And then we got this shot. It was my most insane COD 2 shot I'd ever hit. So I joined the Team Arcane outfit. Many of you may or may not have heard of him. If you don't know who Arcane is, you might know who Fresco is. He's in Obey, and he won the Red RC before. He was that model for 2PS3 out of Matt player. And he was in Arcane with me, and, you know, he was in Arcane before he joined Red as well. So, you know, pretty cool. I used to be in some pretty good teams. And, you know, this was the best shot on COD 2 I've hit, hands down.
Axis eliminated.
Like, just crazy. Just crazy. And then, after that shot, I actually hit a COD 3 slide shot. So this was featured on Random's, top plays or whatever. I actually got featured in the same episode twice. So, we're just gonna skip forward to here. And we're gonna show you guys the shot. Pretty cool shot. You know, I love playing COD 3, to be honest. Let's see. And then, I actually did a COD Classic trick-shotting live. I hit a couple shots. It was in deathmatch, though, so be on the lookout for COD Classic trick-shotting live soon. And then, I actually did a Road 2 kill cam on COD 2, and let me tell you, this was the most insane shot I've hit on COD 2 besides that one. It's been the most insane live comm shot I've ever hit, in all honesty. Look where the guy is. Oh my god, he's right there.
Oh my god, he was so far away. Oh my god.
And I was just freaking the fuck out, dude. Like, it was pretty cringy, but, you know, I'm not gonna lie, I was actually fucking freaking out. So then, the montage I was explaining earlier, expansion, here is a trailer for it. I'm actually gonna play a video after this and let me know if it resembles it. ...1.4 seconds left on that shot, too. So yeah, I edited this myself, and, you know, it's still coming out, it's still in the process of being made. I added more clips onto it, I actually added another game onto it, so, if you want, go check out my Twitter, and you should see, exactly the details on it, but it's gonna be sick, stay on the lookout for that. And, this was a cool shot that I hit on, DLC map on COD 2, boy, Sword Techie Guy Online, the homie.
It was
pretty cool. It was when I was in VBV. So that was a pretty cool shot. And then I was hitting like COD 3 MFs and COD Classic shots and shit. And this was actually my 13th episode by Billy G's himself. I was actually in Orbit, yes. But this was the first Classic episode I've ever read, and I couldn't be happier. ASAP, nigga.
All right. Alright. Get money addict, I'ma get money tatted.
Money in the attics, money in the stashes.
Hey, what the fuck? That was
so there's the road to kill thing.
Full of guns, more money up in action. Taz on Tisa, Jeremy's got Adidas. Mason Martin, Marja, three strap sneakers. Riding with a leecher, student in
a
teacher.
Money over bitches, this is the first shot I hit on thinking of a Lambo, bathing eight camo. Put the money, turn Rocky in the Rambo. Patience is a virtue, life is a handful. That's a select swap, you guys need select swap. I got my hands closed, pace of my brains like games. Got it scrambled, yeah, I feel Rihanna. And I understand, oh, what you think I rap for? To push a fucking Lambo. Now I'm looking back, we said I shouldn't rap. Some slept on me, other niggas took a nap. I found this spot, I found the tree. Me working dead for 21 days. I wonder if you can get me this tree. Yeah, I'm straight, then you could.
Rocky Ben Jiggy, I received from the Wiz, ain't enough to get me.
Allies win.
Yeah, I was freaking out when I hit that. But yeah, that was one of the classic episodes I have, and you know, I love that episode. So then we got, you know, I started uploading a bunch of cool minitages and stuff, and I got a lot of good feedback on them. So this was the one, it was BO1 themed. I actually was going to restart Scale, the team that I showed you guys earlier, so I put the Scale intro in, but, you know, I'm no longer in Scale, and I'm not going to restart Scale, because Scale's like, you know, OG. So then, this is the mini.
If I'm praying, hey, say what's up,
oh
America. Half of you should know me, right? Other half a replica. Shout out to my homie, shout out to that one dude. Oh, wait, fuck that. Ain't nobody held my ass out on this jump through. It's like they finally give a fuck when they see numbers climbing. Most my.
I like, I don't know, sometimes when I get bored I edit, and, you know, I only like to use my own shots. But, yeah, so I play other games besides Call of Duty. I play other FPS games. This is by far one of the funniest games. I used to be at 7F as well. You know, great bunch of guys there, Adam's own work are such great people. So I hit that, and, you know, pretty cool. Obviously not, like, usable, but, like, you know, it's just, like, fun gameplay. You know, something you guys will probably see on my channel. So, then, I actually hit this out-of-map, COD 2 shot. You had to friendly fire grenade jump out of the map, and my boy Zans helped me out. Let's see. So I got out all the way out of the map, and I got on top of these walls to the side outside of the map, and I hit with an assault rifle, so it was pretty fucking cool, to be honest. Let's see. I'm just gonna skip to the part where the actual shot is. One of my favorite shots. I loved when I hit that. I was freaking out. Let's see what else we got here. Sorry I keep saying, like, you know, because I haven't really, like, thought this through. Like, I already recorded it, and it went perfectly. And then my computer restarted, so, like, what the fuck? So I also played PS3. You know, me and my friends, my friend Gecko would get his CFT and we'd do super jump out of the map. But I got on top of this second scaffolding on high rise and I actually had a shot off it. So if you look closely, like, this might look like a regular shot. Like, it might look like I'm actually going off the regular scaffolding. But, I'm not. So as you can see, I'm way higher than I should be, and I'm higher than the crane, for fuck's sake. And I hit this guy over the, little boxes there. And, you know, at the time I didn't record on PS3, but now I do. I don't really play PS3 that much. If anybody wants to do legit out of map on MW2, let me know, and I'll definitely play with you. So yeah, then I rejoined Hype, and here's another multi-FPS game. Here's the 21 Savage song. But this is actually Far Cry and Siege Predator. One of my favorite games to play, especially searching on the board, and fun game to play, really cool. It's actually free to play online, to be honest. Okay, so then I actually played Jebwet and Trick. So I'm actually undefeated in Trick. I'm not gonna play the whole thing, but I'm undefeated in Trick, so let me know if you wanna play.
Uh-oh, what happened? Oh my god, no. Why 144p? That's not what I want. I wonder why I loaded 144p right away if it could handle 720 in 2 seconds. So I hit that with the riot shield and all that, and then Jebwa actually didn't hit it, so then he got a T. And then, moving on to the other cool shot in the video, like, they were all cool, but they weren't, like, all cool, you know what I mean? So it was, like, a dashboard shot with a knife, and, you know, it was pretty dope. Jebwa actually matched it, so it was the best. But yeah, like I said, I'm undefeated in the trick, so anybody step up to the plate. But, yeah, so, back to COD Classic, obviously, BO1, starting to play all these games again. Here's the other game I play that's not Call of Duty. It's pretty cool because there's bounces, and I love bounces. Jesus Christ. Alright, I hit that, and I was pretty hyped about it. You know, let me know if you want to play that game. MWR, my first on MWR wasn't a, like, the generic MWR shot, you see. It actually was with the M16, so if you haven't seen it, here it is. Bang, one burst. The kill cam looks so clean. I did a lot in that shot. It was actually a little bit hard to follow. My bad. I inspected, reloaded, grenade launched, canceled it, and then switched my pistol, reloaded that, went to my grenade launcher, and then swapped again and shot. So, you know, I don't know. I thought it was pretty cool. And then, if you haven't seen this shot yet, this is my best shot, our COD Classic to date.
We take care of each other.
It's the first time I've had a map shot, and, you know, it was great. Now, I'm not going to show you the whole process because it took a long time, but just a bunch of strafe jumping out of map and a bunch of walking, that's pointless. But, so, I actually hit the shot with an assault rifle, and I just skipped it, so here's the shot again. Bang, you know, I was happy to hit that. I've never seen anybody hit before. You know, crazy. So, I'm going to show you a couple cams I've been in to give you an idea. So, I was obviously in VBV. Most of the owners and stuff are in Obey. And I actually made it in the Bravo team, Taj. My shot is actually where we are right now. And there it is. That was pretty cool. And now on to Arcane. Arcane, I was actually in the highlights right here. Fresco was the opening clip. He had a beast BO3 banger. But then here was my shot. You know, they edited it a little better so you could see him.
Oh! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! He was so far away!
And,
oh my god!
You know,
oh my god!
Like, you know, that was pretty cool that I was in their videos. And I was actually in the hit marker video for the out of map on and I was the opener, to be honest. And there we go, you know, just rip-a-roni. And then I'm actually closer to the last video Arcane ever put up, and I couldn't be more on it, to be honest.
Oh my god, he was so far away, oh my god.
So like I said, if you don't know who Arcane is, Fresco came from them, they're such a sick team. Yeah, I don't really know what else to cover. I'm just going to give you guys quick thoughts on the community, and just like, you know, advice for any trick shotters out there looking for it. So if you guys see what I just showed you, take what I just showed you, how the community was, and compare it to right now. Is this really a community? Everybody is just doing things for themselves. Nobody helps anybody else, and nobody talks to anybody else. Some people feel like they're so much better than other people that they don't even respond. And I think that's just ridiculous. It's Earth. We're all human. Like, nobody deserves to not be talked to. I understand it's not people being dicks, but, you know, obviously, it's cool to have that connection with somebody who's big, and it's cool to be able to, like, relate with them and talk to them on a level that's different from you feeling like they're fan. So, let me tell you a story. Bigos used to be leader of Saw.
back then, and Saw was number 5 on the Xbox list and number 3 on the PS3 list on top 30. And, you know, Beagles was overall. I had just started in scale, and, you know, I wasn't a big trick shotter, you know. And I messaged him on Skype, and I sent him a link to this shot, and he replied and told me that it was good. He liked it, and that I should just hit more clips, and one day I'll get in a big team. That's all I needed for motivation. I didn't need, like, hours and hours of hitting clips. Like, that's all I needed was one person to tell me, you know, you can do it. And honestly, you can do it. You know, just because you don't play the same games as everybody, just because you don't hit the same clips as everybody, doesn't mean that you have to in order to be good and in order to be recognized. Stand out. Do something different. Nobody wants to see the same shots over and over again. That's the last thing people want to do. Like, nobody wants to get on and see the same shots. And that's why BO2 kind of got out of style, is because everything has been hit ever. And same thing with Black Ops 3. Now, Black Ops 3 is a great game, but, like, most of the shots I see have been hit already. But, you know, the fact of the matter is, as long as you stand out and do what you like to do and have fun doing it, you know, go have a blast. You know, if people don't want to pick you up because you don't hit, like, the same generic games, let them not pick you up, because in the end, you're going to get more recognition off of your diversity than anybody on a team or any team will give you. Honestly, when it comes down to it, you do not need a team to succeed at all. And I know, like, that's kind of hypocritical because I'm in Halo and everything, but it's kind of not, because I've been solo a lot, I've quit a lot. You know, it's been a crazy ride for me. I've learned a bunch of things. I've learned that friends aren't real. I've learned that people aren't always who they say they are. And, you know, people change. You got to remember that. People change. People quit. People go away. People have real life stuff. Don't ever let gaming get in the way of your real life. But don't ever let your real life get in front of your gaming if that's what you love to do. So for any trick shotters out there looking for advice, just do you and have fun doing it, and don't be like everybody else. Simple. And I think that concludes the video. Actually, I'm going to show you a couple videos I featured in, besides just the videos that I have. No, I misspelled it. So, yeah, me and Bonzo did a cool little video.
Mom! Bonzo said hi. Who? Bonzo.
Hey, Bonzo. My mom said hi to Bonzo. But Bonzo actually did a cool previously, shot while on Road to a Trick Shot. And we were doing elevators out of the map and stuff. And let's see. Bang.
Oh, I hit
Bonzo.
Oh, I hit
him.
Bonzo,
I hit it.
I did.
Sorry. All right. I also featured in a couple top fives. Let's see. Red Random. Let's go to him. Oh my fucking god, dude. Like, it couldn't be more specific. It really couldn't. Alright, Jesus Christ, here it finally is. I actually placed at the number 8 spot, and that's what you just saw a flash of it.
But this was this the other clip that I hit.
That I've seen on this game. Pretty ridiculous. We're heading back old school on some COD 2. And even more old school, we're doing it with a ladder stall. A little 720 wall bang. That's pretty sick, man. You don't see the shots like that very often. Let alone
COD 2. So as you heard, Ryan like said, you don't see shots like that very often. COD.
Heading on to Real 3. We have a pretty sick wall bang. I've been going to see the first ever slide shot. At least I think this is the first ever slide
That's
shot.
That's how I got in 360. Twice.
And he goes so far, dude. You go so far in COD 3 with slide shots. That's so sick. That's so awesome. A little 360. Whatever.
So, yeah, I was in that video. Let me show you one more. I'm going to show you Bonzo's top plays. I hit a nice, really cool, really, really cool out of map. No, not an out of map. Not an out of map. It was an SND shot on COD Classic. One of my first really, really good SND shots on COD Classic. So let's just show you where it is. Right here. So here we are. I would make the number two spot.
I was doing a video of him the other day, and he hits a Call of Duty one shot. I mean, Call of Duty fucking one. You don't understand how hard that shit is. Okay, finally.
But anyways, guys, that's gonna end the video. You know, go check me out on all three of these sites: Twitch, Twitter, and YouTube. And you know, definitely let me know what you guys think of this video. I just wanted to give you guys some background information on who I am and what I've been through, what I've done. Expect to see live trick shotting as the next upload, hopefully on either COD 1 PC or COD Classic on Xbox 360. We'll figure it out. But anyways, guys, this has been Zio. Have a great day, and peace out.